Thank you. Sure, you have a lot more repetitions. 1, 2, 3, 4.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up the house of the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, God Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You created us, unique human creatures created to love and be loved, created to seek relationship with each other and with you. We give thanks to you for your gift of our sexuality, that which calls us into intimate relationship with each other. We give thanks to you for your gift of those we love and who love us, especially those in covenant relationship with us, who embody your presence to us in many and holy ways. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, most especially Robert Brown, Ricky Toms, Leslie Caldwell, Hank Wilson, Al Cyphers, and Lehman Bennett, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, come to the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him you showed us a new way to be in relationship with you and with each other, to care for one another and the stranger, and to see you in many different ways. Through him you showed us a new level of acceptance and new ways to worship you. Through this community which you have called together through our concern, our passion, and our seeking to know you, we learn about you more. Your sustaining love and your own passion for justice and liberation for all. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke it, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink all of this. This is my blood poured out for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is alive. Christ is risen. Christ,
pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. Strengthen us for our witness and our service in your name. Increase our courage and wisdom as we live and work for your reign. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your holy church, with your holy Son and the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, God Almighty, now and forever.
Amen.
Because there is one bread, we who are many are one body. And so I ask you, the bread which we break, is it not a sharing in the body of Christ?
It is.
Because there is one cup, we who are many share in one covenant of love and salvation. And so I ask you, the cup which we share, is it not a sharing in the blood of Christ?
It is.
The table is ready. The feast is prepared. The wine is unfermented. The bread is gluten-free. I invite you to come forward as you are led. Share on the table of our God. Love of God as we bless each other, saying,
Now may the peace of God go